Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a response to one of the questions that I got on my another video, that is how to create glitter using Photoshop. So I was asked if we could create glitter using Illustrator, and the answer is yes, you can. So let's begin. Start by creating a new file. Let's go to file and new. Let's use a 5x5 inches artboard and let's click on this advanced. Let's make it RGB and 300 ppi. Click on create. Go to your rectangle tool, or you can press M on your keyboard. If you cannot see the rectangle here, right click and then choose rectangle. I'm just going to draw a rough rectangle. Size does not matter. Make sure your stroke is turned off. And then for fill, leave it as white. It's completely okay. Now we're going to apply three effects, one after the another. So let's go ahead. First effect, sketch, note paper. And this seems fine. So my settings are 25, 10, and 11. You can definitely play around with the settings. It's completely okay. You can increase or decrease the graininess. You can make it 20. Let's try it with 20, and I'll show you how to edit it later if you don't like it. Click OK. Next, we're going to apply the next effect. Go to texture and then stained glass. This is set to 2, 4, and 0. I think it should be all right. I'm not going to change any of these settings. And you should know the cell size is nothing but these tiny things over here. So if you put like 4, so it kind of makes it much bigger. And you can create bigger textures, I guess. But something like 2, 4, 0 is kind of, it's my default settings, and I'm just going to keep it at that. The last effect we're going to apply is sketch and tone edges. And here you can change it, like, let's make this 24, okay. Smoothness, you could reduce it a bit, maybe around 2. And then contrast, you can keep it at 16 and click OK. So as you can see, you have your glitter ready, but it's black and white. And if you go ahead and select some color, it's not going to change the color of the glitter. I'll just undo that. So what we're going to do now is go back to your selection tool and click outside. Let's keep it at that. And now go to your rectangle tool and click and create a rectangle right on top of it. And this rectangle, we're going to fill it with the color that we want. So probably I'll just go for this red. Now you can go back to your transparency mode. If you cannot find this here, go to window and then transparency right here. So in the transparency, you have two things. One is opacity, like which decides how opaque your color is supposed to be. Keep it at 100. The next one is a blend mode. So this one, we're going to change it to overlay. And voila, there you have. Your glitter is ready. And this is basically how you create glitter. I just forgot to mention one thing, and that is how do you edit your effects settings once you have already applied them. So to do that, we'll just try it out today. Once you've applied your blending mode, it's a little difficult to change the settings. So we're going to do this process before we apply the blending mode, that is the overlay mode. So I'm just going to undo this change by pressing Command Z or Control Z. And I'm going to bring this rectangle down here. Now go back to your previous rectangle, which has the base glitter, and go to your Appearance tool. If you cannot find it here, you can go to Window and Appearance. Here, if you scroll down, you can actually see the three effects that you have applied: note paper, stained glass, and tone glasses, tone edges. If you uncheck this eye, it kind of shows you how it would look without that effect. So now I'll go back to my note paper. You just have to click on it, and it'll show you the settings. And if you want, you can change the settings here. Like I can make it 10 and click OK. And this is going to get applied onto your texture. So this is how you go back and change the settings or the appearance of anything once you have already decided on how to do it. So let's bring back this rectangle on top of this. And now go to your transparency and let's make it overlay. You know, feel free to go ahead and, you know, try out these other things, because they kind of give out very nice, you know, beautiful textures, and it's fun to play around with these things. So basically, yes, that's how you create a glitter effect in Illustrator. And I don't know how good the quality of the glitter is because I've never printed it out once I've created using Illustrator, but it's up to you guys to try it out. I think it should be fine. So thank you for watching this video, and Chris, I hope I answered your question. See you next time.